Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture on the topic gas power cycles. This is lecture number 9. The topic is problems in diesel cycle. In the earlier lecture, lecture number 8 also, we solved a few problems in the diesel cycle. And in this lecture also, we solve additional problems in the diesel cycle, and all the problems are taken from the Anna University question paper, so that it will give the confidence to the student by solving an university question paper. And the learning outcome for this lecture, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems in the diesel cycle. And this is example number 6 from May 2014 question paper. An air standard diesel cycle has a compression ratio of 8 and the heat transferred to the working fluid is 1800 kilojoules per kilogram. The pressure and temperature at the beginning of the compression stroke are 1 bar and 300 Kelvin respectively. Calculate the pressure and temperature at each point of the cycle, the air standard efficiency and the mean effective pressure. Assume Cp equal to 1.005 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and R equal to 0.287. So, we write down the given data, the compression ratio R equal to 8, heat supplied equal to 1800 kilojoules per kilogram, pressure P1 equal to 1 bar, T1 equal to 300 Kelvin and Cp equal to 1.005 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and R equal to 0.287 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And we calculate the specific volume initially and after the isentropic compression, before and after the isentropic compression. V1 initial specific volume RT1 by P1 0.287 into 300 divided by 100 kilopascal, that equal to 0.861 meter cube per kilogram, and V2 equal to V1 by R. So R is the compression ratio, so 0.861 divided by 8 equal to 0.1076 meter cube per kilogram. Now we take the PV diagram of the diesel cycle. So, the 1 to 2 isentropic compression process, 2 to 3 constant pressure heat addition process, 3 to 4 isentropic expansion process and 4 to 1 constant volume heat rejection process. Now, we take the isentropic compression process, the pressure volume relationship, pressure temperature volume relationship. So, T2 equal to T1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1. So, V1 by V2 equal to R. So, T2 equal to T1 into R to the power gamma minus 1, which is 300 into 8 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 689.2 Kelvin. And the pressure P2 equal to P1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma, where V1 by V2 equal to R, the compression ratio. So, P1 into R to the power gamma. So, 1 into 8 to the power 1.4 equal to 18.38 bar. Then for the constant pressure heat addition process, we are given the amount of heat added. So, P3 equal to P2 equal to 18.38 bar. So, QS heat supplied equal to Cp into T3 minus T2. So, from this equation, we calculate T3 equal to T2 plus QS by Cp. So, the answer T3 equal to 689.2 plus 1800 divided by 1.005 equal to 2480.2 Kelvin. And we calculate the cutoff ratio, RC equal to V3 by V2, which is T3 by T2, equal to 2480.2 divided by 689.2 equal to 3.6. Now, we take the isentropic expansion process, 3 to 4. So, T4 equal to T3 into V3 by V4 to the power gamma minus 1. So, this V4 3 by V4 equal to RC by R. So, T3 into RC by R to the power gamma minus 1, which is 2480.2 into 3.6 divided by 8 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 1802.07 Kelvin. And P4 equal to P3 into V3 by V4 to the power gamma, which is P3 into RC by R to the power gamma, which is 18.38 into 3.6 divided by 8 to the power 1.4 equal to 6 bar. Now, we calculate the efficiency of the cycle. So, eta diesel cycle efficiency, eta d equal to 1 minus 1 by r to the power gamma minus 1 into RC to the power gamma minus 1 divided by gamma into RC minus 1. So 1 minus 1 by 8 to the power 1.4 minus 1 into 3.6 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 into 3.6 minus 1. So calculating the efficiency of the diesel cycle is 40.1%. And we calculate the heat rejected. So heat rejected constant volume. So QR equal to CV into T4 minus T1. So 0.718 into 1802.07 minus 300 equal to 1078.48 kilojoules per kilogram. Then we calculate the work done in the cycle. So W equal to QS minus QR equal to 1800 minus 1078.48 equal to 721.5 kilojoules per kilogram. Then we calculate the mean effective pressure equal to net work done divided by the swept volume. So 721.5 divided by 0.861 minus 0.1076 equal to 957.66 kilopascal. Now we write down the answer to the problem. So the pressure and temperature at all salient points are pressure in bar, temperature in Kelvin. So P1 equal to 1 bar, P2 equal to P3 equal to 18.38 bar. And P4 equal to 6 bar. The temperature T1 equal to 300 Kelvin, T2 equal to 689.2 Kelvin, T3 equal to 2480.2 Kelvin, and T4 equal to 1802.07 Kelvin. The theoretical air standard efficiency is 40.1%, and the mean effective pressure is 957.6 kilopascal. Then we take the example number 7 from November 2014 question paper. 1 kg of air is taken through a diesel cycle. Initially, the air is at 15 degrees Celsius and 1 bar. The compression ratio is 15. The heat added is 1850 kilojoules per kilogram. Calculate the ideal cycle efficiency and the mean effective pressure. So, we are given the given data, we write down. So, R equal to 15, P1 equal to 1 bar, T1 equal to 15 degrees Celsius, which is 288 Kelvin. And the heat supplied equal to 1850 kilojoules per kilogram. And we draw the PV diagram of the diesel cycle. 1 to 2 isentropic compression process, 2 to 3 constant pressure heat addition process, 3 to 4 isentropic expansion process, and 4 to 1 constant volume heat rejection process. For the 1 to 2 process, isentropic compression process, T2 equal to T1 into V1 by V2, so where V1 by V2 equal to V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1, where V1 by V2 equal to R compression ratio, so T1 into R to the power gamma minus 1, so that is 288 into 15 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 850.8 Kelvin, and P2 the pressure equal to P1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma, so where V1 by V2 equal to R, so P1 into R to the power gamma equal to 1 into 15 to the power 1.4 equal to 44.31 bar. Now, for constant pressure heat addition process, so P2 equal to P3 equal to 44.31 bar, we are given QS equal to Cp into T3 minus T3 minus T2, so T3 equal to T2 plus QS by Cp, which is 850.8 plus 1850 divided by 1.004 equal to 2693.3 Kelvin, and we calculate the cutoff ratio. RC equal to V3 by V2, which is T3 by T2, equal to 2693.3 divided by 850.8 equal to 3.16. So, using the constant pressure heat addition process, we calculate the temperature T3 and the cutoff ratio 3.16. Then we calculate the efficiency of the cycle. So, the diesel cycle efficiency equation, we write down the equation eta equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1 into RC to the power gamma minus 1 divided by gamma into RC minus 1. So, substitute the numerical values 1 minus 1 by 15 to the power 1.4 minus 1 into 3.16 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 into 3.16 minus 1. So, calculating the value, the answer diesel cycle efficiency is 0.551. Which is 55.1%. Then we calculate the work done. Work done W equal to eta into QS. Efficiency into QS. So, efficiency is 0.551 and the amount of heat supplied equal to 1850 kilojoules per kilogram. So, substituting 0.551 into 1850 equal to 1019.35 kilojoules per kilogram. Then we calculate the specific volume, initial specific volume and the final specific volume for the compression process. So, initial specific volume is RT1 divided by P1. So, 0.287 in temperature is 288 divided by 1 bar is 100 kilopascal. So, 0.287 into 288 divided by 100 equal to 0.8266 meter cube per kilogram. Then V2 specific volume, V2 equal to V1 by R. So, using the compression ratio R, 0.8266 divided by 15 equal to 0.0551 meter cube per kilogram. Then we calculate the mean effective pressure. So, mean effective pressure equal to net to work done divided by swept volume, which is V1 minus V2. So, 1019.35 divided by 0.8266 minus 0.0551 equal to 1321.25 kilopascal, 1321.25 kilopascal. So, the answer to the problem, the ideal cycle efficiency is that 55.1% and the mean effective pressure is 1321.25 kilopascal. Then the example number 8 from May 2018 question paper, we have the mean effective pressure of the ideal diesel cycle is 8 bar. The initial pressure of the initial pressure is 1.03 bar and the compression ratio is 12. Determine the cutoff ratio and the air standard efficiency. Assume the ratio of specific heat of air for the air is to be 1.4. We write down the given data. Mean effective pressure is 8 bar, P1 equal to 1.03 bar, compression ratio R equal to 12. And gamma equal to 1.4. Now, we have to calculate the cutoff ratio and the air standard efficiency. Now, we write the equation for mean effective pressure. So, equation of mean effective pressure for the diesel cycle, P1 into RC into R to the power gamma multiplied by RC minus 1 minus R into RC to the power gamma minus 1 divided by R minus 1 into gamma minus 1. So, we are given P1. R value, gamma value is a constant, we substitute, mean effective pressure is 8 bar equal to 1.03, P1 equal to 1.03 into RC is the unknown, so R equal to 12 to the power 1.4 into RC minus 1, again it is unknown, minus 12, R is 12 into RC to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by R minus 1 is 12 minus 1 and gamma minus 1 is 1.4 minus 1. Now, we calculate the 12 minus 1 into 0.4 into 8 is 35.2, cross multiplying 8 into 11 into 0.4 is 35.2 and the numerator is, and again you take the 1.03 to the denominator, so that is also taken to the other side. So, finally what is left, 1.03 and RC into 12 to the power 1.4. So, 12 to the power 1.4 into RC equal to 32.42 RC into RC minus 1 minus 12 into RC to the power 1.4 minus 12. Now, the minus 12 is taken to the other side. So, 32.42 RC square. So, multiplying RC square minus 32.42 RC minus 12 RC to the power 4 equal to 47.2 equal minus 47.2 equal to 0. Then, simplifying. Dividing by 12 throughout for simplification. So, 2.7 RC square minus 2.7 RC minus RC to the power 1.4 minus 3.93 equal to 0. Now, there is no other option. We have to solve the equation by trial and error method. So, what is trial and error method? We assume a value for RC. RC is varying between maybe above 2, we can take above 2 and below 3, that is the range we can select here, and we substitute for RC value and we will verify this equation. So, I substituted 2-3 times, the RC value is 2.175. So, how to do it as a student for your practice, first you substitute 2 value, 2 is RC, you substitute here and calculate. So, you find the difference, it should be equal to 0. Then you go to the next value 2.1, next value 2.5 or 2.75. So, like something like that, you have to increase fractionally and you have to make the equation 0. So that is what trial and error method. So I found using the trial and error method RC equal to 2.175. Then the efficiency of the diesel cycle, we take the equation diesel cycle equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1 into RC to the power gamma minus 1 divided by gamma into RC minus 1. So substitute the numerical values 1 minus 1 by 12 to the power 1.4 minus 1 into 2.175 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 into 2.175 minus 1. So calculating the value, the efficiency equal to 0.557, which is 55.7%. So the answer to the problem, cutoff ratio equal to 2.175 and the efficiency of the cycle is 55.7%. So we take the next question from May 2019, example number 9. The following data relate to both auto and diesel cycles. Condition at the start of the compression 100 kilopascal, 300 Kelvin. Maximum temperature is 1500 Kelvin. Temperature after expansion is 700 Kelvin. Take Cp equal to 1.005 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Cv equal to 0.718 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And R compression, the gas constant is 0.287 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And the specific heat ratio equal to 1.4. Determine the pressure, temperature on salient points, compression ratio, maximum pressure, efficiency and mean effective pressure. So all the parameter you have to calculate for one auto cycle and label the values on the PV and TS diagram. Number two, diesel cycle and label the PV and TS diagrams. So you have to solve the common data is given, you have to solve for auto cycle then for the diesel cycle. This is from May 2019 question paper in Anna University. So we write down the given data. So P1 equal to 100 kilopascal, T1 equal to 300 Kelvin, T3 equal to 1500 Kelvin maximum temperature, T4 temperature after expansion 700 Kelvin, Cp equal to 1.005 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, Cv equal to 0.718 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and R equal to 0.287 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and gamma equal to 1.4. So first we take the auto cycle. So the pressure, volume and temperature entropy diagram of the auto cycle are shown here. So 1 to 2 isentropic compression, 2 to 3 constant volume heat addition, 3 to 4 isentropic expansion and 4 to 1 again constant volume heat rejection. Now for the compression ratio, so we have the relationship between, we are given temperature. So we take the temperature relationship for the expansion process. So, R equal to V4 by V3. The ratio of V4 by V3 equal to V1 by V2. So, V4 by V3 equal to T3 by T4 to the power 1 by gamma minus 1. Right? How to remember? V4 by V3 equal to T3 by T4. So, reverse of the temperature 1 by gamma minus 1. So, substituting 1500 divided by 700 to the power 1 by 1.4 minus 1 equal to 6.72. So, the compression ratio is 6.72. And the specific volume, we calculate the specific volume for the process, V1 equal to RT1 by P1, which is 0.287 into 300 divided by 100 equal to 0.861 meter cube per kilogram. And V2 specific volume based on the compression ratio, V1 by R, so 0.861 divided by 6.72 equal to 0.128 meter cube per kilogram. And we know for the constant volume cycle, that is auto cycle, V1 equal to V4 and V2 equal to V3. Then the temperature after compression. So, T2 equal to T1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1, which is T1 into R to the power gamma minus 1. So, 300 into 6.72 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 642.8 Kelvin. And we calculate the pressure. So, P2 equal to P1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma. So, P1 into R to the power gamma equal to 100 into 6.72 to the power 1.4 equal to 1439.85 kilopascal. And for the constant volume heat addition process, P3 equal to P2 into T3 by T2, which is equal to 1439.85 into 1500 divided by 642.8 equal to 3360 kilopascal. And P4 equal to P1 into T4 by T1 for the fourth process, constant volume heat removal process, 100 into 700 by 300 equal to 233.3 kilopascal. Then we calculate the efficiency of the cycle, eta equal to 1 minus 1 by r to the power gamma minus 1, which is 1 minus 1 by 6.72 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 0.533, which is 53.3%. Then calculate the heat supplied, QS equal to CV into T3 minus T2, so 0.718 into 1500 minus 642.8 equal to 616 kilojoules per kilogram, and work done equal to W equal to eta into QS, so 0.533 into 616 equal to 328.33 kilojoules per kilogram. Then the mean effective pressure is net work done divided by the swept volume V1 minus V2, so 328.33 divided by 0.861 minus 0.128 equal to 447.9 kilopascal. Then we take the diesel cycle and we have to draw the PV and TS diagram. We calculate all the parameters for the diesel cycle now. First for the compression ratio, again we take the V3 by V4. So V3 by V4 equal to V3 by, we multiply by V2 and divide by V2, and this V4 equal to V1 for constant volume heat removal process. So V3 by V2 into V2 by V1 equal to RC by R. So, V3 by V4 equal to RC by R equal to T4 by T3 to the power 1 by gamma minus 1. So, T4. So, T4 equal to 700 divided by 1500, that is to the power 1 by 1.4 minus 1 equal to 0.149. So, RC equal to 0.149 R. So, this you have to remember. RC equal to 0.149 times of the compression ratio. So, we take the next slide. So, we draw the PV and TS diagram and label all the processes 1 to 2 isentropic compression, 2 to 3 constant pressure heat addition, 3 to 4 isentropic expansion, and 4 to 1 constant volume heat removal. Now, for the compression process, 1 to 2 compression process, T2 equal to T1 into R to the power gamma minus 1, which is 300 into R to the power 0.4. Now, we write the RC value. For the second process, constant pressure heat addition process, RC equal to T3 by T2, which is 1500 divided by T2. T2 is the unknown. So, from the previous equation, we substitute the T2 here. So, RC equal to 1500 divided by 300 into R to the power 0.4. Now, RC equal to 1500 by 300 into R to the power 0.4. This is one expression for RC. We have another expression for RC here, 0.149 R, RC equal to 0.149 R. Now, we take the two equations. So, if we substitute for RC here, 0.149 R equal to 1500 divided by 300 into R to the power 0.4, and we cross multiply. So, R power 1.4 into R equal to R into R power 1.4 equal to R power 1.4 equal to 1500 divided by 300 into 0.149 equal to 33.56. Now, R equal to 33.56 to the power 1 by 1.4 equal to 12.3. So, the compression ratio for the diesel cycle is 12.3. And the cutoff ratio RC equal to 0.149 times of the R value, 0.149 into 12.3 equal to 1.83. Now, we can calculate other parameters. So, once we know the R value, compression ratio and the cutoff ratio, we can calculate the other parameter for the diesel cycle. So, we calculate the temperature T2 equal to T1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1. So, T1 into R to the power gamma minus 1. So, 300 into 12.3 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 818.62 Kelvin. And we calculate the specific volume. V1 equal to RT1 by P1, so 0.287 into 300 divided by 100, which is 0.861 meter cube per kilogram, and V2 equal to V1 by R, which is 0.861 divided by 12.3 equal to 0.07 meter cube per kilogram, and V3 equal to V2 into T3 by T2, 0.07 into 1500 divided by 818.62 equal to 0.128 meter cube per kilogram, and V1 equal to V4. So, all the specific volume values are calculated. Then we calculate the pressure values. So, P2 equal to P1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1. So, P1 into R to the power gamma, because V1 by V2 equal to R. So, 100 into 12.3 to the power 1.4 equal to 3356.35 kilopascal. So, P3 equal to P2 equal to 3356.35 kilopascal. So P4 equal to P1 into T4 by T1. So 100 into 700 by 300 equal to 233.3 kilopascal. And we calculate the efficiency of the cycle. So eta equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1 into RC to the power gamma minus 1 divided by gamma into RC minus 1. So substitute the numerical values 1 minus 1 by 12.3 to the power 1.4 minus 1 into 1.83 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 into 1.83 minus 1 equal to 0.5804, which is 58.04%. Then we calculate the heat supplied. So heat supplied equal to Cp into T3 minus T2. So 1.005 into 1500 minus 818.62 equal to 684.79 kilojoules per kilogram. And we calculate the work done equal to eta efficiency into heat supplied, which is 0.5804 into 684.79 equal to 397.45 kilojoules per kilogram. Then we calculate the mean effective pressure, MEP, equal to net work done divided by the swept volume, V1 minus V2. So 397.45 divided by 0.861 minus 0.07 equal to 502.46 kilopascal. And so all the values are calculated for both auto and the diesel cycle. All the pressure and temperature at all the salient points, the amount of the efficiency, the mean effective pressure, everything is calculated. So we stop here, and these are all the books you may use for the additional information on this topic and to get more practice problem in the diesel cycle. I have published a book on thermal engineering. You can refer to it for additional problems, and other books are mentioned here that also you can refer for additional information. I conclude this lecture with a quote from Dr. Kalam. Dream is not which you see while sleeping. It is something that does not let you sleep. So we all work hard to be a successful man in our life. So these are all the books I published earlier. So Design of Transmission System, Turbo Emissions, Heat and Mass Transfer, Operations Research, Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion, Thermal Engineering, Fluid Mechanics and Machinery. Also, I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures of all the subjects mentioned here. Also, I am uploading the solution for the gate question paper. So it is absolutely free of cost. You subscribe the channel and use the video lectures for your better learning and to pass in the gate examination. So thank you for watching. So you please post your comments on the comments box in the YouTube video, and you subscribe the channel, and you can write to me to my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification. I will sincerely answer to your queries. So thank you for watching once again. We'll meet you in the next video lecture with additional problems from the Anna University question paper.